in the right spot to be seeing a tornado, but the fact that we got that funnel cloud report on one of them west is something concerning. Continue to watch. And so here's the thing. As a storm spotter, do you call this a funnel cloud? I mean, probably not. In the daylight, you'd have a better vantage point on it, but we have this thing wide open. It does not look this bright if we went outside right now. But these little fingers hanging down, you're going to have a little twisting and turning with it just because of what we call wind shear. But we don't have that twisting and turning extending all the way down to the ground on this.
Just
John, yes.
On one, I've got that little, just take a look at that, right to the south of Tupelo, just a little spike up of something.
Okay, you have it on one. I'm going to pull up one. I have one on screen there. I see. Are you talking about over Verona?
Yeah, Verona and Tupelo. Do you think there's something trying?
Well, do you think that that's, again, on 45?
Zion, that's probably a little, if you backtrack back a ways to Furs and Zion.
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead and backtrack it real quick.
Going back, just right over from Zion, if you follow it, that's that little bit possibly. I mean, you know, it's a little bit of a circulation going to the south of Tupelo, or over the city of Tupelo right now.
Okay, so, I mean, just a little bit there. And like we saw a minute ago on Tower Cam, circulation over doesn't mean circulation down. But there are a couple areas there. I mean, you can see right over top of our television station there, right where it says WTVA was where that was. And now you can see it's now just a little northeast. So what we were looking at, those little things dangling down, those could potentially have been one of those funnel cloud reports. Now, did you see the dangly stuff getting all the way to the ground? No. So let's flip this thing back around to the east. Apologize, because it's just going to fling around. We're going to be looking from the precip side of this. It's going to be kind of hard to catch anything on it. I'm going to crank the brightness as high as it goes. I got to remember 53 so I don't break my tower cam forever, but don't see anything there to get overly worried about. So there is circulation happening above us. That circulation is not as impressive close to the ground on this. So we're going to disengage from this thunderstorm. Now that we have, I feel pretty confident, poked and prodded this one enough to be pretty confident of what we're looking at on this. We'll come back to this here in a minute if all of a sudden it looks like that storm over Tupelo is going to get a little more uppity. And the rain, of course, has really picked up here at the television station. Okay, we're looking south out of our Tupelo tower cam. Let's zoom that in just a little bit. And low-hanging clouds, yes. We'll have to monitor this closely. John, if you can, stay on tower cam for a minute here and just watch tower cam. And by that, I mean, go ahead and go over to the controller. Get on the controller and let's just watch this just to make sure. Okay, because there's, I mean, lots of little interactions on this line, including now one that's just a little south of West Main and Coley. And so let's go to the wind mode on storm track Doppler radar on this. 60, 70 miles per hour, that's just above the surface. Okay, but that's not directly at the surface. And let's just make sure there's nothing else that's stronger at this moment. No, this is easily the strongest. So let's stay with it. And so that scan coming in as of about 1 minute ago. Back to tower cam, because that's this area we're zooming into. This is the Natchez Trace Parkway looking southward out of our tower cam here. That is the area in West Tupelo that may or may not be some sort of a circulation on storm track Doppler radar. You can see the cloud itself. It's just moving so fast when they're moving 80 miles per hour. And so this is the area there that makes up the tower of the thunderstorm there. So this is the zone we're obviously watching back in this zone there in case something is popping up. But we're looking through some rainfall here, so that's going to be a challenge to be able to see anything out of this at this moment. But let's go ahead and bring it in just a little bit more. And John, I'm going to come off camera for just a moment here just to finesse this just a little bit. It's a little difficult to run this thing this late at night because it's, you know, cameras work a lot better when there's actual light out there.
National Weather Service did just issue a severe thunderstorm warning with this storm for Itawamba, Lee, and Tishomingo until 12:45. It says possible tornado.
Okay, so they're still going with possible tornado on this. They're looking at that rotation we're looking at. And so at this moment, the best thing we can do is stay with this tower cam for a moment just in case. Because this is different, by the way, for all those folks that have the bad memories of 2014. This is not the same thing. This is not 2014, we knew it was a day for bad tornadoes. This is a maybe, possibly, kind of, probably not situation as far as that's concerned, as far as any tornadoes is concerned. But that doesn't mean this won't have some wind damage with it. So, I mean, I see what looks to be low-hanging clouds. I do not see a tornado. John, I'm going to hand this thing back over to you. Keep poking and prodding it and see if we come up with something different. But thankfully, that's some good news there. If we're not convinced, that's a good sign. Okay, so the interaction we had, the little rotation there near Bissell, is now weakened just a little bit. My radar keeps jumping back a little bit. I put it right over top of the Natchez Trace Parkway and Main Street in Tupelo is where that rotation probably is at this second. That's where our tower cam's looking. We're not seeing anything out of it. And that's why we've disengaged from that. Precip mode on storm track Doppler radar. Well, we do have a couple other things back here. This thunderstorm pretty much over top of Mantachie at this moment. Folks there in the Eggville community. This is some wind gusts. This has actually gotten a little more organized here in just the last couple of minutes here. Right pretty much along, I need to double check my road there here in a second. I think that's 371 there. Just east and northeast of Mantachie. That's what we call a bow echo. That's probably wind gusts that are in excess of 65 to 70 miles per hour. That's probably our strongest storm at this moment. I believe that's the one that came right over top of our television station here. Moving it northeast, the only place that comes into mind is Sandy Springs at 12:09. Current time is 12:05, and that's just a mention as to how fast these thunderstorms are moving, practically 80 miles per hour. It's faster than you should drive on the interstate. Let's go to the wind mode on storm track Doppler radar. I keep getting weather calls over here because they keep issuing new warnings. And luckily, no interactions on that that would be overly strong rotation at this second. I'd say same thing. And now we have our most recent one. It's over top of Morville. That was one that previously was more organized just a couple minutes ago. So I now have it just a little east of Morville. Again, 371 heading toward Mantachie. You're going to get the same names three or four times on a lot of these as they move through. But expect on all of them 65 to 70 mile per hour winds. Let's watch Tupelo Tower Cam again. John, any official reports on this?
Not that I'm catching. I'm searching on anything that's either being talked about Tupelo area on Twitter, or there's nothing that's popping up.
I'm glad to hear that. That's a good sign. And by the way, for those folks watching us on Facebook Live, when your satellite signal gets out, you can do that. You can also watch us online, WTVA.com/live or the WTVA News app. Those are both free ways to do it, and it's definitely something I would recommend at that point. Okay, we would be seeing it. If there was a tornado out of this thunderstorm over Tupelo, we would have seen it. We will have been looking the exact direction to see it. I'm not seeing it. John's not seeing it. Hold on. Are you seeing it, John? I might as well just, and it's up on the big screen. Do you see anything that looks like it?
No.
There's
just a lot of low-hanging clouds over the southern, over Tupelo and southward.
Okay. I don't want to just sit here and, now that we've been out of a tornado warning for about 25 minutes, they keep issuing these tornado possible ones. We keep getting funnel cloud reports every time we try to send you back to programming, and that's what ends up locking us here and keeping us here. But the reality is that I don't think we need to be as worried about tornado possible as we need to be worried about just strong straight line winds out of some of these thunderstorms here. So I'm going to give a latest track at about that same 80-ish miles per hour for most of these thunderstorms that have warnings on them at this point. And you see Belmont, pretty much now, the next couple of minutes. Shannon at 12:15 for the next one upstream, and that's the problem with some of these is there's two or three are upstream. And then Tremont, we're looking at about 12:36 for you. Russellville at about 12:40. Strong winds, from time to time rotation. There have been a few funnel clouds. But at this point, we've yet to have those tornado reports come in, thankfully. So let's send you back to regular programming on NBC WTVA. let's keep you on ABC. I swear spotter reports are just joking with me today. Okay, so storm report coming in just a minute ago from Itawamba County of just at, that would be 12:08 of, in Mantachie, of a funnel cloud, reports of trees down there and a funnel cloud that was pretty low to the ground. Let's stick with it then for a few moments here at the very least to look at this. And that was on what we called that bow echo a minute ago. Remember we were looking at it on radar and it had a little arch shape to it? That was this storm when it was over top of Mantachie. Looks much more like a straight line wind producer. There's going to be things that look like funnel clouds. And unfortunately, all of these spotters don't have the benefit of these cameras that keep the iris, as they call it, open and let all that extra light in. They're going with the naked eye. And so as we go back a scan, this is what it looked like when we had that report of the funnel coming in just a moment ago. And so this is likely straight line winds, unlikely to be a tornado, but likely to be causing damage because we've now had reports just in a moment ago out of that thunderstorm there when it was moving through Mantachie and a funnel cloud low to the ground. And we saw a funnel cloud out of that thunderstorm when it moved over top of our station and it was pretty low to the ground. So that would be right over top of Sandy Springs. That is tracking in the direction of Red Bay, and at that 80-ish miles per hour that it's been moving. For Red Bay, I'm going to catch Belmont in this as well, hopefully. Pleasant Sight, Piney Bend. Belmont, we're 7 minutes at most. Strong straight line winds is what I'd be most concerned about out of this. Perhaps some rotation. Piney Bend, as we mentioned, about 15 minutes. Red Bay, 9 minutes on that. A rotation, yes. Tornado, I'd say unlikely. The cold air has kind of undercut this. I'd say unlikely at this point. But, you know, wind is wind, and wind causes that damage. Let's just double check one last time so we can kick it back to regular programming on everything but ABC. And let's do that at this point. So we're going to continue some coverage on ABC WTVA just a little bit longer here, and then possibly drop off of that and stay on Facebook a little bit after that and on WTVA.com. Here's what you need to know. Number one, most of these thunderstorms, I would be highly surprised if we had more than one tornado the rest of the night. I don't know if I'd be highly surprised if we had one, but I think it's unlikely at this point. We're really past that tornado potential. But what is likely is there's going to be some strong gusty winds. And so the trees are going to be thrashing around outside. The wind's going to be blowing 60, 65, and in times maybe even 70 miles per hour. And so you want to treat this carefully by staying in the strongest part of your house. That would be the middle part of the lowest floor. Let's stay there just in case something happens. But really, I'd be more concerned about the straight line winds than anything else. We'll be monitoring things here. We'll be on ABC WTVA a little bit longer. Keep it here for the best coverage. Again, here alongside meteorologist John DeLucic. Apologize for the little breaks here as we try to keep as many people possible watching whatever programming's on at 12:14 at night, and trying to get some of those folks back to their regular scheduled program, especially when we're now not in a tornado warning situation. But we're still high impact enough that we do have some population centers here with certainly some strong wind gusts, perhaps even just a little bit of rotation. Tupelo Tower Cam, as you noticed a moment ago there, has gotten to the point where it's not terribly usable. We're now fully in the rainfall. That's a good sign. That means we're nearing the end. Certainly up here toward the television station, North Saltillo, Guntown, you're done. And if you're watching me staying up late, go to sleep. You're in good shape. And we'll do some more go-to-sleeps here than we did on the typical coverage a minute ago there. There is still one thunderstorm with some strong straight-line winds. I'd say gusty straight line winds. I don't know that we can verify that it's damage producing, but certainly approaching 60 mile per hour straight line winds here, stretching from Bissell back southward towards Shannon, moving toward the east like they all are at about 80 miles per hour. And the reason you see like different lines here glowing, there's about four different warnings going on here, at least there was a moment ago. I think we're now down to, I think maybe only two warnings out of this. And certainly, if we track this one forward at that about 80 miles per hour.
If, just to mention, there's the storm down there southwest of Tupelo down toward the Shannon area. If you look backtrack toward Bruce, you could see maybe it did a little bit of split going on.
Did it?
Yeah. If you go backtrack to about Bruce and then track it to our area, you can see north end. It wasn't a big time split, but you can see.
A little split?
Yeah.
Okay. So there's some times on your screen there. Joiner pretty much in the next moment or two. Middle of Tupelo at 12:17. ICC, you know, we're talking about ICC Tupelo at 12:18. And eventually Mantachie at 12:26. Let's go ahead and find that storm there, and let's check what you were talking about there.
Look, if you go back to about Bruce area, and then you go, just follow it as it goes, and the north end looks like it just, it separates.
You're right, it does split. Wow, that is interesting. It does split, and that one goes almost more east. That's important because when you have what we call deviant storm motion, a storm that's doing its own thing, they typically are stronger, maybe have more rotation, depending on how they're deviating. But yeah, you break off this one there. This illustrates the strong winds aloft that are more in this direction. And what's really interesting to me, I think John would agree with me here. I don't know that I anticipated the storm motion on our strongest storms to be straight east today. I expected more northeast. So that's kind of interesting. I think that's been one of the things that's kind of helped this. It's also slower. Am I wrong? I feel like this is an hour or two slower.
It is. I mean, talking about the
timing with everything.
Yeah, it looked like we would be looking at, well, it's now 12:16. Well, it's close, but yeah, a little bit slower.
You're right. It's fairly close.
A little bit slower, as you did mention.
Let's hit some other storms here, northeastward on this, just to check in case we have some rotation. I think we're done. I think we're gonna drop off ABC here in a minute. There's certainly going to be some damaging wind gust potential here, but if you're in a sturdy structure, you're gonna be fine. You don't even necessarily have to be in the middle of a sturdy structure unless you have those kind of trees around you that you know you gotta worry. So there's still going to be some strong straight line winds with this. And by the way, we have had more reports come in of some of that occasional wind damage, like the report from Boonville from that storm earlier that had a tornado warning on it. And now more confirmation from the police chief, Michael Ramey up there. Appreciate him. Roof off a business blocking all of 2nd Street and a tree blocking 9th Street up in Boonville from that thunderstorm there earlier on. Chief says to stay in your homes and stay away from those two streets. Crews are out working to clear them. And I mean, it's midnight. Do we really need to be going out any place at this point? I know there's some folks that do work different shifts at work. Just be very cautious. These thunderstorms are going to have some gusty winds with them and could from time to time still have rotation. I think that tornado risk is not high end by any stretch, but something we still have to monitor. Let's see here. I'm going through some Twitter reports myself. Now, Kim Gray, we have, I'll see if I can find some of these pictures here, because it looks like we've had here we are. Here's a picture of that roof that was off in Boonville. My computer here's gotten slow. John,
you got also Samantha.
Retweet a couple of those pictures and okay. I'll pull them up on the iPad.
All right,
if you would, because for whatever reason my computer has gotten really slow on me. It's like I didn't restart it before we started today, because you know all computers behave like that, even good ones.
Some damage from the Boonville area from Samantha Bullock. I just retweeted that.
Okay, so let's go ahead and pull that up here. Some tree damage from Boonville. Okay, so this was from Samantha in Boonville. That's a tree. Doesn't look like the strongest kind of tree there, but a tree that was snapped. Appreciate Samantha with that photograph there. You can always send in your photographs using Twitter. We appreciate all of you that do that on nights like this. There's a lot of folks, and I do have that picture of the damage. Let's see if we can get that in now. The damage to the building there. Stick with me for just a moment. Here's that building damage we were talking about a moment ago from Boonville. What that tells me, by the way, on the roof, that's some kind of a flat roof there, or that does not look, I mean, that's not reinforced. You have the tin making up the roof there, and I can't tell if that's boards or if that is, if that's that red steel that some buildings have there, but certainly taken off. It is damage, and that typically when you get into that situation there comes from straight line wind gusts, but something we'll have to monitor. I think Kim sent in a couple other photographs here. Let me see if I can get one of those others on, so stick with me for just a moment. And so this looks to be at least some one of those little signs with the arrows down, and certainly heavy rainfall. You can see the cars navigating through that as well. So Twitter, Facebook, ways you could send those in. Twitter is the easiest way. It's the most likely way that I'll actually end up seeing it. One thing I'll also show, and we always say we'll show these, we never make time for them, but I'll give Cody a little credit here for he and his family, Langley Fire there with their little safe place selfie as they're all cuddled up and have their pillows and blankets, made a little pallet in the safe part of their house. Encourage you to do that as well, and thank you so much for your patience on a night like this with all the ifs and maybes and possibles that we do have. The storms continue tracking eastward, all with a speed. We haven't in the last hour verified speeds on any of these, so let's do that now. So give me just a moment here to check to see how far this one has moved, and we'll go to the last half hour to see if we need to update it. That 80 mile per hour speed was back when these were moving. You see, now they're down to like 60, 65. Okay, so let's start adjusting that back down to 60, 65. Okay. And so let's address, first and foremost, I'm going to address the strongest thunderstorm. There's going to be one or two ahead of this. Richmond Community at 1226 there, Abney and 1229, Tremont at 1241, and Bexar at 1248. All these thunderstorms will continue to produce lots of lightning and gusty winds. Tornado watches do continue for much of the area until 3 a.m. I find it hard to believe that it'll be extended beyond that. I really think the tornado threat is pretty much past. There'll be still some straight line winds, and that's the reason why we're going to drop off here on ABC WTVA. We'll keep the stream going. We'll modify kind of what we do a little bit behind the scenes here on WTVA.com. If at any time it looks like tornadoes are now much more possible, much more likely, we'll come back on. We'll do more coverage on air here. But at this moment, that rotation has weakened. They're all showing a little rotation, but none of them are in a spot where it could produce tornadoes. So we'll have to see how this will work out. And hopefully what we've had has been straight line wind damage tonight. It's not impossible that storm that moved over Prentice County and hit Boonville and had that damage I showed you a minute ago, that could have potentially been a tornado, but it was in that part of the thunderstorm and had a lot of straight line winds, and so you just have to be careful regardless. But we'll monitor things behind the scenes and we'll come back on if necessary. Keep it here for the best coverage. Out of all this. And Marquise, are we on stream or where are we at? What do you think? Are we still on ABC?
We're off ABC.
We're off, so are we off all TV? Okay. We're on the stream? Okay. Okay. Thank you. I'm going to take my jacket off because it's super hot. It's like it got to practically 80 degrees today in here in the television station and everyone left the heat on. Give me just a second to get rid of this so I can think straight. I'm going to bring over a chair.
That's a damage from, I'm going to retweet this one.
Okay. Appreciate that. Where was that damage from?
That's Shannon.
Shannon, okay. And I apologize that we can't really show all the graphics on our live stream on Facebook. We can on our live stream on the website. And so that's why I would, if that's what you're looking for, I'd direct you that direction. If you do have reports of damage, you can try to list them in this. We appreciate that. Hopefully, we don't have any reports because we don't want to see that, but we've had plenty just simply because of the straight line winds that we've had today. And then what we call the gradient winds, the winds caused by the pressure gradient sucked into the storm system, have certainly been strong as well. Okay, let's also address here for a minute some folks that we haven't hardly talked about, namely this area south here of Houston back toward Winona and Eupora. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on it because it's really simple. This is not going to produce tornadoes. It just, Something would really have to change for that to happen. I just don't see it at this moment. I don't see any of this producing tornadoes from here on out. I could be wrong. I can say that more freely on a live stream where I'm not covering my tail feathers as much as I am when, you know, we're on TV. But I don't really think that there's going to be a whole lot of tornadic activity out of what's left tonight. And really, for the last hour, we've been in this zone where it's primarily, really the last hour and a half, it's primarily straight line winds. I say that, and watch this, it's going to change my mind. Fulton, we're watching for you at this moment. Let me go look at the wind mode on StormTrack Doppler radar. Only 23 miles per hour for that pixel-to-pixel wind change there. Hey, Zach, when you get a moment, I'm just curious. I'm just going to bring you on camera for a moment. We'll talk about what you've had behind the scenes and kind of recap some stuff just so I know where everything stands, because this is, you know, oh, come on. Okay, fine. No, not going to come on camera. Okay, what do we got?
We're seeing some pictures out of Boonville.
Mm-hmm. Primarily Boonville, that one. That was clearly one of probably the strongest thunderstorm.
Yeah, right now, that's the only thing. There was a couple on Twitter from Shannon.
Mm-hmm.
Tree down blocking an awning or whatever.
You know what's interesting about that? Have they even had a thunderstorm in Shannon yet? I mean, they finally have. Was that recent?
Yeah, it was recent.
Okay, so that would have been with the most recent one that came through there. Okay. WTVA. Did you retweet it?
No, not yet.
Yeah, go. Okay, yeah, when you retweet it, I'll go ahead and pull that one up, and appreciate you, all your reports you send in. Let's check the tweets.
Trying to get, we got a
also
tweet.
Emails.
A tweet from Brittany Culver, but can't get her to get us a location.
She's where was that down. Navy Marine mom? Okay, that was the one from Shannon there. Okay, so that's some tree damage there. The last work, is that what it was? Okay.
Are we on?
We're on live stream and we're on Facebook. Yeah.
Okay. If you can get Brittany Culver to tell us where she's, I've been trying to get in touch with her through Twitter the last several minutes. Where she sent us three photos from a downed tree on her car, but she's not reported back where she's at.
Okay. So Brittany, if you're on Twitter, if you're on Facebook, if you'll let us know where that's at, we'd like to pass that along to the Weather Service and go back and double check and see if we can verify how this is all working out. And appreciate all those reports you've been sending in, all those strong wind reports, raining even worse. I mean, I believe it. You know, there's going to be some really heavy rain, some really strong wind gusts here. Pontotoc is pretty much done. I'll double check that for some spots here in a second. Let's go back to the radar while I'm looking through some things here we're looking at. All this, let's do the go to sleep. We haven't done that. We should have done that on air. I forgot. About go to sleep on air. Let's put go to sleep on here. Everything in this zone back here is go to sleep. Okay? So everything back here west and north of Tupelo, you really probably could include Tupelo in that. This is all go to sleep back here. We're not that entertaining, and if you sleep better tonight, you'll be better for church tomorrow, you'll be better for work next week, and it's going to be a hard week anyway because it's right before Christmas, and you know how that work week goes, even for meteorologists. I'm stoked. but I love my job. Yes. Nothing.
Any other counties being
Let's double check. I'm trying to think back now on some of these that we've had. Let's double check with Mantachie, which would be at Awamba County. Let's double check Tishomingo County. Those two, I don't think we've heard back from there. And we might as well check Lee County. We've had a couple of these move through that were close, but I figure we would have heard it on the scanners and stuff if it had been here. So I would check Itawamba and Tishomingo counties. Okay, thank you. Appreciate it. So many folks behind the scenes that make John and I look intelligent. And it doesn't look like my Facebook Live is updating the comments anymore, unfortunately. I'm going to see if I can pull it up on a different computer here, just so that way I can check some of your comments. I'm going to treat this more interactive than we treat our on-air coverage, partially because it's also a severe thunderstorm warnings we're dealing with here as opposed to tornado warnings, so I can look at some of the newest stuff here coming through. Power's out at Elvis Presley Lake. Appreciate that report there. Monroe County, severe thunderstorm warning. Yes. You see what I did there? Did you see what I did there? I'm just going to say everything's bad all night, and then nothing will be bad. Because I said, Monroe County, Chickasaw County, not overly worried about that. Let's look close at it. Let's investigate it more. I still say Houston, everything back the west there, you're still in go-to-sleep mode. That severe thunderstorm warning that came out from Monroe County, of course, issued by the National Weather Service in Memphis. Okay, let's look at the wind mode. So, I mean, those are the two areas we're looking at, just east of Houston there, closer to Okolona. Let's look at the wind mode. Let's see if there's any interactions. There's not. So, yes, some strong straight line winds, 60 miles per hour, heavy rainfall, gusty winds, all that's happening. Thankfully, though, not tornadoes out of this. It doesn't look anything like that at this point. Gusty winds east of Houston. Hey, Mikey, can you guesstimate me what wind speed, or can you tell, are the winds really like thrashing the trees where they're all over the place? There's something called the Buford scale that I should probably pin in here that would help people be able to give us good reports. The rain is definitely there in Red Bay. Andy there, power out in Prentice County. Can you tell me about where that is so we can pass that along? Blue Springs, you're in go to sleep mode at this point. Fulton, we're still in a zone. We have to watch it. And no power on the west side of Houston and Transformer Blue. We're definitely going to have a lot of these power outage issues simply because of the strong winds. I mean, you take winds and it slaps two power lines together. It can arc, cause a transformer to blow. That might not be the, I apologize for the electric company folks out there, that might not be the exact way it happens. That's the way it's in the past been explained to me. So that might not be perfect, but that's part of what goes into causing some of these power outages. Sometimes it's poles that are down, sometimes it's just the same way if you have your microwave and your vacuum cleaner and something else going and it pops the circuit. Maybe that doesn't happen on houses anymore. I haven't done that in a long time. But growing up, we did that, and I always got in trouble. Iuka, you're pretty much in the clear at this point. Belmont, I'd say the same thing. Pontotoc, I'd say you're in the clear at this time as well. Let's go to the precip mode on StormTrack Doppler radar. Certainly Amory, folks there in Monroe County, in Aberdeen, you're still kind of ahead of this in that zone. We're watching closely. Let's do a StormTrack on this. Let's keep that 65-ish miles per hour toward the east and northeast. I didn't catch Turon on this. I'll try to catch in a minute. But Treblock at 1232. The Una community at 1239. Wren at 1243. Flynn at 1249. Aberdeen at 1253. Hatley at 1254. And Detroit, Alabama at 106. Hey, guess what? My voice held up, John.
That's good.
Wasn't really sure that was going to happen. Last time I lost my voice as bad as I lost it, the last severe weather event, it took a year to come back.
Very good stuff that your voice can hang on.
Now, it's a little rough, but it's still there. Okay. So let's go look back toward Itawamba County at this point. Let's check down the line. I mean, you can visibly, just using the eye test, I love when they say that in football, and I never believe the eye test, but just use the eye test on this. Yellows, oranges, yes. Reds and purples, no. That tells you the depth of how strong the storms are. These are substantially weaker. That's why we're not talking about them. There's going to be gusty winds. There'll be some lightning. There's still going to be 60 mile per hour wind gusts just out of this in some cases, mainly 40 mile per hour wind gusts out of the north and west, but we're in good shape. Okay, by the way, when I look over here at these sheets of paper, that's been Zach all night, so thank you, Zach. From Tishomingo County Sheriff John Doherty, tree down on Highway 13. Car hit it, but no injuries. Other than that, nothing. And by the way, that's always my greatest fear going home, and another reason not to travel this time of night, is what tree fell that wasn't down the last time you went through. And I was worried on my way into work today just on what we call these pressure gradient winds. We're going to have some of those. Thankfully, we didn't. Thank you so much, Zach. Appreciate that report coming in. I'm going to check some Facebook reports here for a moment here. Let's see here. Still, a lot of folks still reporting some of the damage around Boonville there, but it looks like it's the same reports over and over again. Thankfully, not a lot of new reports, which is always kind of a good sign, something I like to hear. Let's go back. Here is a tree, Brittany, with
she
a
never,
tree.
She never called in to say.
Tree. That,
she never didn't. Tweeted or nothing. You know, it's a weird.
I'm gonna go ahead and retweet it. Did you retweet back at her?
I did tweets a couple of times, but can't get an answer on.
Okay, well, let's see.
I was trying to do some research on the online, but
No luck on exactly where she is?
There's someone in Red Bay area or in Alabama, but I'm not sure that would have been. That would have been too early.
Okay. So I'm gonna move back up our line here for a moment, just to kind of give a wider shot while I kind of go through some of the tweets. Out of all this severe weather stuff, the one thing I've never mastered is being able to go through all of your tweets, your lots and lots of great tweets and good information that you give at the same time as we're on the air. For whatever reason, I just don't have quite enough time to get that done. Okay, so luckily it's only been a couple of those. I'll show the tree pictures here if we can, to see if we can figure. Hold on, Brittany. I'm in Pontotoc County, right off of Old Highway 9. Outside of Cherry Creek. Okay, now that we got that, we can go ahead and show her pictures, which looks like a tree on a car. Let's get that popped up so you can see it on air. And so a couple shots here of that tree on the car. Not giant, but certainly that looks like a new windshield there, amongst other damage. Oh, way more than a windshield. Wow, you couldn't really tell that on the first one, but that's the problem with it being dark. Or maybe you could at home and I just couldn't tell it here. That's not good. Hate to see that. It looks like she might have, I can't tell if her windows are fogged up or cracked. It looks like they might be just fogged up there. But that's not good. Trees on cars. Not a huge tree, but certainly doesn't have to be a huge tree to be an issue there. So that was out of the thunderstorm. Can't tell if there's any more damage due to the darkness. And I'll retweet. We need to get you hooked up. Oh. I thought you were Zach. I need to get you hooked up on our TweetDeck so you can see all the stuff coming into us, too. Can you see all that? Do you have TweetDeck? Okay, we need to get you. Remind me Monday if you're not here when we're done. And speaking of that, were you working today naturally, or did you come in?
I was at the movies, and I just... The movie ended, and I was like, might as well come here.
Might as well come to work, okay. If you want to go, you're probably okay. We're definitely past the peak. And I wondered if that was Marquise's question as well. Yes, we're definitely past the peak. Just leave our stuff open here. Who else is here?
Trevor's in there. I told him all he had to do is punch you up on the board.
Don't worry about this. Just hit the board, and we're good.
Not only doing weather, Matt can read minds too.
Well, it's 12:30, and like everyone else at home, everybody watching, looking at me right now, has the same question. Can I go home now, Mike? I'd say the same thing.
Should have heard the shocker when I told Marquise. I think you're gonna be hanging around here a couple extra hours today.
Yes.
And it's on day that you're usually not even here.
Yeah.
Yes, I appreciate you coming. When did you just come in too?
Nah, actually was working for Rich.
Okay. Okay, yeah. I apologize. Give us a couple seconds here to figure out some stuff behind the scenes. I would say all three of you can go home. We're probably okay.
Lee County, Alicia, the city spokesperson, says she hasn't reported. No reporting.
Good. That's fantastic. That's why the worst of it didn't look like it hit Tupelo. It looked like it was a little north. So that's more of that. Want more of that? Okay. But I'm sure there's reports we haven't gotten yet, and they've come in on Facebook and. And unfortunately, the Facebook Live problem, I can only go back so far. So.
I just checked Facebook. There's not been too much come in.
Okay.
Just a little bit here and there, a couple of pictures, and that's it. Minor.
Okay. Minor stuff. Okay, good. That's what I like to hear. Okay. Well, thank you, guys. I appreciate you. Thank you so much. Okay, have a good night. So that tells you something, by the way. If we're dispatching people here behind the scenes, could a tornado still pop up? Yeah. Will a tornado still pop up? We have a trampoline picture. You know, I'm surprised it took this long to get our first trampoline picture. But we got a trampoline picture coming in here. Let's retweet that just a moment. Because trampolines do an excellent job of catching that wind. And so I just always generally expect, oh, I don't even have it popped up behind me. God, I bet that meant I didn't have the pictures of the tree damage a second ago popped up behind me either. But there is the trampoline picked up. And so there you go. So trampoline picked up. There's going to be a lot of that because it catches the wind. And just in case I didn't show it a minute ago, because that's entirely possible, because it's 12:39 at night for everybody. Tree on car. Hard to see, sad to see. There's probably more of that than we've heard about. Okay, let's come in close. Let's go eastern Itawamba County. These are severe thunderstorm warnings. That's why we're taking a little bit more of a lackadaisical approach to this, because